Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to create a pivot table with simple easy steps and why do we need pivot table. Let's start. So first we'll go through the theory part and then we will go through the practical part. Let's first understand why do we need to use pivot table when we already have some option to create normal table in our Excel. So pivot table helps us to summarize our data with very easily and to create the report based on those data. Let's say we have a data of 100 rows and we want to calculate some information based on some parameter and we want to create a report. So if we have to do this with the help of normal table, then it's going to take a lot of time. But I will just show you with pivot table, you can actually calculate your data, summarize it, analyze it, and create a report in just, you know, within 5 minutes. So let's see how it happens. So we have taken a sample data here, if you see. So here we have some data for parameter store, region, fruits, price, units, and total. And we want to create pivot table for this data. And we want to analyze our data based on different parameters. So first thing, we are going to select our whole range. We can also do without selecting the range, but then we have to give the range specifically in our settings. But easy way is to select the range. And while doing this, we have to make sure that none of our rows or header is empty and none of our cells are merged. So I'm explaining you, none of the header or rows should be empty and none of the cell should be merged. Now, once you select your data, you have to go to your menu and you have to click on this insert tab and then you have to click on the pivot table. After that, you will get this pop-up where you have some options like select the table range and where you want this pivot table to get created. Let's see how it does. So we will give our table range here. We can manually enter the table range or we can select the whole table and automatically our range will be here. Now under choose where you want the table report to be placed, we have two options, new worksheet or existing worksheet. If you choose existing worksheet, then you have to give the location as the number of cell number, or else you can select a new worksheet where your pivot table is going to get created. Then press OK and it will take you to the next screen. Your screen will look like this if you select your pivot table to be created in a new worksheet. So let's understand what are these fields and this four section. So these are all the four parameters which we have on the tables, which will be here. And we can actually select which one we want under our pivot table report. Now these are the four section. If you click on each of these parameters by default, all the non-numeric fields will get added under your rows. And all like numeric fields will get under your values and time and date hierarchies will be added under your columns. But we can change the rows and columns at any time. Just you have to drag it and drop it to the proper place. So we have to drag the field to the target area where you want. Now let's see how to create a pivot table practically.